Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial. Let's see how to use Adobe Photoshop Elements 2022, an outstanding image editing software for beginners and amateurs. Photoshop Elements is a photo editor that is part of the Adobe Elements bundle, a collection of software editors provided by Adobe under a perpetual license without any subscription plan. This bundle includes Adobe Organizer to manage and organize your photo collections, and Premiere Elements, the main video editor, to correct and adjust your footages. All these editors are available for both Windows and Mac OS. To learn more about Adobe Premiere Elements 2022, do not lose our dedicated tutorial in this playlist. When you open Photoshop Elements, its home screen page opens, showing useful tutorials, tips, and suggestions to start and edit your photos. It also includes a search bar on top to look for any specific topic or feature. On the right, you can open any previous photo in progress or any other Adobe Elements product you have from the bundle. Click on Photo Editor to open Adobe Photoshop Elements. At this point, you just have to import your photos. You can either drag and drop these into the interface or go to Open in the top left corner to browse for these. All your photos will be collected within the Photo Bin panel at the bottom. Let's start working with the Quick Workspace, the simplest one to correct single photos straight away. Its preview on the center shows the photo selected from the Photo Bin panel. You can zoom in and out with your mouse wheel while holding down the Alt or the Option key and pan around with the Spacebar key. Around the preview, you have several tools and panels you can use to edit the picture. Use the rotate buttons at the bottom to rotate by 90 degrees, the Organizer button to open the current photo on Adobe Organizer, and the home screen button to come back to the home screen page just seen. The toolbar on the left collects all you need to adjust and correct your image. Click on any tool to enable it and adjust its properties from the Tool Options panel at the bottom. Enable the Straighten tool to align the photo by clicking and dragging on it. This also crops and zooms the photo automatically to fit the original size. To crop the photo, enable the Crop tool and click and drag to define the region to be saved within a rectangular grid. Then, click and drag it to move it and use its nodes to resize it, holding down the Shift key to save its aspect ratio. Drag outside the grid to rotate it instead. At the bottom, use Cancel or Commit to either undo or apply the current grid. When dealing with portraits, enable the Eye tool to remove red eyes by clicking and dragging over these. Make sure to include each eye completely, adjusting options at the bottom. In addition, use Whiten Teeth to brush on teeth and make them brighter. With the Healing Brush tools, you can perform advanced corrections to remove imperfections or entire parts from the image. Enable Spot Healing Brush to click and remove small imperfections within your brush size. Whereas, use Healing Brush to enhance the photo by copying and brushing pixels taken from a reference point represented by a cross that moves with your mouse cursor. Fix the reference by holding down the Alt or the Option key and clicking on the interested part, and then brush freely, setting options at the bottom. Remember that you can undo or redo previous actions made with the Undo and the Redo buttons. With the Type tools, you can drop amazing text over your photos. Enable the Horizontal or the Vertical Type tool to click and drag on the preview and type any text spreading horizontally or vertically. If you do not see the text completely, Enlarge the box enough by dragging its nodes. You can select any text and customize its properties at the bottom, such as format, style, size, and color. Click on Commit to apply all. Enable the Text on Shape tool to drop text around any shape. Choose the right shape and click and drag to drop it. Then click on its perimeter and type in, resizing the text if this is too big. Whereas use the Text on Custom Path tool to draw any freehand shape that you can apply in order to type text laying on it. To manage all these pieces of text, you can enable the Move tool and click and drag any to move. Use the nodes to scale and drag from outside to rotate. Double-click within any box to type in again. The Quick Workspace shows advanced panels on the right when you click on the buttons in the bottom right corner. With the Adjustments panel, you can apply corrections and enhancement on colors and details by dragging on the sliders or hovering and picking any ready template. Remember to undo with either Control or Command and Z or the Revert button. With SmartFix, you can adjust brightness and contrast with a few clicks. Open exposure and lighting to balance exposure and brightness levels of the image, low lights, shadows, mid lights, mid tones, and highlights. With color, adjust the color intensity with saturation, the range with hue, and the color appearance with vibrance. Whereas use balance to apply amazing color filters with temperature and tint. Opening sharpen to reduce the photo blurriness. You can see the result of your modifications by changing the view in the top left corner. Before represents your original image, and it is compared with the modified one under after. By default, all these adjustments are applied on the whole photo. You can use several selection tools to define limited regions within dashed contours in order to apply the adjustments within these, leaving the rest of the photo intact. Enable the Quick Selection tool and click and brush to select all the regions that share the same color gradient. Whereas use the Selection Brush tool to brush and select regions precisely without any extension. With the Type Mask tools, you can click and drag and type any text in order to create a selected region with the same text shape. Also in this case, you can choose between an horizontal or a vertical text orientation. All these selections sum up together to realize a unique region. While using any selection tool, hold down the Alt or the Option key to refine this area by removing any part from it. Press the Escape key to delete all selections instead. Besides the adjustments, you can also apply effects, textures, and frames, with the difference that these do not interact with selected regions. Check these out. On top, you can switch to the Guided Workspace to apply advanced corrections and effects by following guided steps explained on the right within the same Quick Workspace. Other effects can be found within the Enhance tab. You can always undo with Control or Command and Z. Open the Expert Workspace to go advanced. This collects all the tools seen on the Quick Workspace, including others derived from Adobe Photoshop, such as the Blur and the Sharpen tools to adjust blurriness and clarity, the Smudge tool to drag pixels, the Sponge tool to adjust color saturation by brushing on the image, and the Dodge and the Burn tools to adjust the brightness level. You also get the brush and the pencil tool to draw freehand with a defined color and brush size and style. The Expert Workspace also allows to have multiple objects and photos in the same place. Thanks to its layer structure, you can show with the Layers panel on the right. For example, you can open any image, select it all with any selection tool, and use Control or Command and C to copy it. Then switch to another image tab and use Control or Command and V to paste it, creating a new layer over it. As seen for the pieces of text, you can enable the Move tool to move, scale, and rotate each layer. From the Layers panel, you can also hide or show each of them on the preview. In the same way, you can select any portion of the current image and cut it with Control or Command in X, and then paste it with V, making an independent layer. Any checkerboard area represents full transparency without any color or pixel on it. For more information about the Expert Workspace, make sure to catch our dedicated video tutorial. Now let's see how to save the current image shown on the preview. Go to File, Save As, and render your image as either a JPEG or a PNG file. Make sure to choose PNG to save any transparency present on the image. You can also go to Create or Share to export your image outside to burn DVDs, make collections, or share it online. Thank you very much for watching this video. Make sure to check out our playlist guide to learn more about Adobe Elements 2022.